Namaste. Welcome to Yoga Bliss with Shelly. And I'm Shelly. Welcome to this feet opening and rooting into the earth practice for my camping edition, nestled in Steamboat, Colorado. Bringing love and attention into your feet by sitting in your favorite Sukhasana or crisscross applesauce. Taking a moment to tune into the breath for a triple burner, a three-part breath. Bringing the breath into the belly, expanding through the ribs and into the upper chest. Imagining your torso as three parts filling up the air from the belly, expanding through the chest, and filling up your glass through the top of your chest and gently pouring your water out. As you bring your breath in, gently massaging your feet, massaging into the arches, wiggling your toes, and really giving that extra love and attention. Maybe bringing one foot on top of the other and really rubbing and bringing love and the intention of opening the feet and really grounding and rooting into the earth. Taking the time to rub the arches, maybe in between the toes, getting the heels, maybe coming into Baddha Konasana, gently bending and pushing the knees forward, exhaling up, inhaling, pushing the knees wide open, rooting up and pressing forward. Really, soles of the feet, kissing soles of the feet. As you bend forward, gently pressing with the elbows. Inhale, raising the arms up, pulling the left wrist with the right, opening and expanding at the side body, stretching the intercostal muscles, the muscles between the ribs. Exhaling, sinking down and floating to rise, opposite hand, pulling in the opposite direction. As I'm really absorbing nature, rooting in through the sit bones here. Exhaling, gently bringing the knees together, twisting to your side, and really bringing the awareness into your feet. Grabbing a rolled up towel here or a blanket or a pillow and placing that really close to your lower back and gently resting down and opening up the heart for Matsyendrasana, the supported fish. You can bring your feet into Baddha Konasana, allowing the body to open and drape over your towel, your blanket or pillow. Maybe rolling side to side, really opening up the heart here and bringing love and attention into the feet. Bringing the knees up and gently doing some ankle rolls, rolling the ankles and bringing the wrists to life. Bringing opening and awareness of love into your feet. And really giving the attention. We're always on our feet all day long. So my idea was to get our weight off of our feet. Exhaling to the opposite foot. In rolling that ankle out. And as we bring our feet and allow them to become weightless, let's let them heal a little bit here. Exhale, really rolling the wrist back and forth, rolling the ankle here, while you're opening up your chest at the same time. In yoga, we might have a specific thing we're practicing, but we really want to open the whole body to inhale, planting the feet into the earth, tuning into the sit bones. You can remove that towel or bring it on your lower back. I move mine horizontally so that my shoulders are going to rest on the earth. Bending the knees up to the chest here and hugging into the chest for a little apanasana. Exhaling each leg up for Viparita Karani, a legs up the wall variation without the wall. Soft bend to the knees. In really bringing love and light into the feet. As I was saying, we're always on our feet, so really look at your feet upside down and just give them gratitude. Bending in and down for happy baby. You can grab the outsides of the feet, insides of the feet, maybe giving them a little bit more loving rub, because they are weightless here. They're inverted. And just really giving them love and giving an inner smile here as you're just bending in, plantar flexing, dorsal flexing, planting into the earth. And gently, with core engagement, release each leg onto the earth and bringing them back up again. Really gently and mindfully, right leg down, left leg down, inhaling, left leg up to the sun, and exhaling down, using that core of the body while rooting down in the shoulders and the hands. Inhale, rising up both feet up to the earth gently with core engagement. Exhaling, right foot tapping toe, left toe tapping to the earth. Inhale, raising up right. Exhaling a little bit, sinking further up into the sun. Gently, mindfully exhaling, tapping right foot, right, left toe down to the earth. Inhaling, touching the hands and the heels if you can. Inhale, raising it for a supported bridge here. You can support on your blanket or your pillow. Or inhale, raising up, shooting the sit bones up to the sky, hugging the thighs together. Exhaling, resting down. And really tucking the thighs in together. And inhaling, raising up at the pelvis. Really opening up the body here. And grounding into the earth. And exhaling, the right foot up. And really driving and planting down to the earth. And inhale, raising that foot up to the sun. Inhale, rise. Well, you're really opening that foot into the earth while you're weightless on one foot. Inhale, driving the pelvis up and feeling the shake and the burn. And tuning into that knee if it's wanting to drop in or out. And really hugging in and gently tapping that right foot down to the earth. And rooting into the four corners of the foot. And exhaling, driving the left foot up to the sun. And driving the pelvis up for this supported, this bridge variation. Inhale, rising up, exhale, sinking down to the earth. Inhale, rising, using the strength of the core and the back and the foot rooted into the earth, gently, mindfully tuning back down to the earth, both feet planted into the earth, and relieving yourself of that pillow or that blanket for this bridge, really driving up, tuning into the glutes and the hamstrings, exhaling, dropping the right hip, neutral, left hip down. Inhale, neutral, dropping the right hip. Inhale, rise, neutral. Running a variation to the left, center, and then right. Raising up the left. Rising and gently falling. Rising, using the strength. Exhaling, twisting up the spine. Slowly and mindfully using that engagement. Exhaling down to the earth. Inhale, rising up. Rising up with the hands to the side. Really rooting in through the shoulders. And really squeezing the shoulder blades together, making sure that your feet are not too far forward and maybe stepping them back a teeny bit. And exhaling down to the earth. Inhale, raising up for a moment here. Rock-a-bye baby, rocking up onto the sit bones and down to the earth. This is little Mr. Jack. Inhale, rising up. Inhale, rising up for a boat pose. Exhaling, one foot down to the earth, bringing that little man over to my side. Being safe by the river. Inhale, raising up for a boat variation. Palms up to the sun. Exhaling, right foot down to the earth. Left foot, power through invisible wall. Really rolling and bringing the awareness and setting the intention of rooting into the earth. Plantar flexing, dorsal flexing, pressing down and opening up the foot. Spreading the toes wide open, side to side. Rolling the feet maybe in a way that feels good, planting the opposite foot down to the earth. And inhaling, still using the engagement of the core and rolling out the ankle. Exhaling side to side, plantar flexing, dorsal flexing. Remembering that breath of filling up your glass of water. As I'm surrounded by water, I'm just loving this breath of filling up your glass of water and exhaling. Inhaling if you can, power up through a full boat. Exhaling if you can. Exhaling down, stretching the legs down where you can stay down on the earth if this doesn't work for you. Inhale, being okay with where you are. Exhaling down to the earth. Pressing yourself a little bit further, maybe coming in for a start. If you're feeling wobbly, just go to what feels good. Exhaling down to the earth, grounding those four corners of the feet. Coming in, bringing the side, twisting into tabletop position, creating a starfish hand. Really opening up, rolling the biceps out, pressing up through the shoulder blades, grounding through the pointer finger and the thumb, and walking out your dog for Adho Mukha Svasana. Really walking out the dog, pedaling the feet here, taking a little movement in this slight inversion. Really tuning into your foot and walking the feet to the short edge of the mat for a forward fold. allowing your body to ragdoll, hang in this forward fold here. Exhaling, elbows intertwined to elbows, or just allowing the feet, the hands to walk to one side of the foot and gently walk and twisting the opposite foot. And just allowing yourself to find a little movement. Inhale to rise flat back, imagining there's a board on your back. Exhaling down to the earth, soft bend to the knees, soft bend to the back. Exhaling to rise, sinking. Inhale to half rise, slowly then slowly journey with the spine up, last shoulders and find the neck, rooting into Tadasana to the four corners of the feet. In yoga, there's two corners in the front and two in the back foot. Inhale, rising the arms up to the sun. Inhale, Anjali Mudra, exhaling arms, swan diving forward, opening it for a robin's breath. Exhaling palms, kissing palms back to heart center. Inhale, diving forward, opening up the wings, squeezing the shoulder blades together. Exhaling forward, tuning into your breath and your movement here. Really tuning into that breath, breathing in to what feels good for you. Then stepping to the center of your mat. Inhale, rising up one foot and really bringing the awareness into that foot and just really pressing the toes into the earth while you're rooted into the earth with your other foot. And really pressing up, positioning up on the heel and forward folding into that upper thigh and the hamstring. Keep a soft bend to the leg. And if you can, walking down to your shin or to your foot, exhaling, twisting in and twisting out that foot. Just finding a little movement that is a little unusual for you. Just moving, planting the opposite foot into the earth and bending those toes, rising up at the heel, and then doing the opposite, pressing into the heel and walking the hands with a soft bend to the knee, either down to the shin or touching at the toes here. Bringing that intention of opening up the feet, healing and rooting into the earth, flexing out with the heel, in with the heel, and really rotating and moving those feet around, feeling the weight disperse. Inhale, rising up on the tippity toes, bringing the arms overhead. Inhale, using that strength of the core, powering up, exhaling down and posting into there. Inhale, rising up that whole body, bringing the weight into the tippity toes and then dropping into the heels. Inhale, rise. This is a beautiful Qigong movement. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, dropping down and sinking and posting into those heels. Really rooting into the earth through the four corners of the feet. Exhale, twisting. Allowing the arms to softly twist and wrap around the lower belly. This is another Qigong-inspired yin and yang practice. Exhaling, just allowing your body to rotate and sway. Really hugging those arms in as you're rooted like a tree into the earth. Your hips and your upper body are swaying just like a tree is rooted into the earth. And it may be a windy day and the wind is blowing, but you're rooted. Really breathing. Exhaling. And gently bringing the arms up more towards the rib cage and tuning into that breath with each twist. Exhaling with an audible. Tuning into the movement and the breath of the body. Twisting as you're rooted into the four corners of the feet. And slowing, slowly, slowing, and slowly coming to neutral on your own. And finding a little stillness here in Tadasana, the mountain. As you're rooted into the earth, feel the energy that you have just created. As you feel rooted into the earth and hearing the sounds of nature, heel toeing, opening up the feet, heel toeing, toes facing the corners of the mat, coming for a goddess pose, sinking the sit bones down into the earth, bringing the awareness into the hamstrings and the calves, and slowly rocking on the heels, rocking side to side. This is one of my favorite parts of yoga, is just being free in your own skin. So really swaying at the hips here as you're down in this goddess, elongating through the spine, just finding a little free movement, leaning arms up, swinging high like a silk, and lifting up the toes of each side. Imagine you have a little string and you're pulling those toes up. Now pulling your heels up. Allowing yourself to find a little free movement that feels good for you, zipping up that core. Inhale, rocking, pelvic rocks. Pelvic rocking forward. Imagine there's a bowl at your pelvis and you're tipping it in, tipping it back. Really pulling that core together, forcing the hamstrings, really working that body and enjoying movement. And then just move it, Shake that booty, move those hips. Really move the heels and just find a little movement that makes you feel fun. Maybe hopping side to side, feeling the burn, and smiling inside and allowing it to reflect outside. Finding a little of your own movement that feels good for you in this beautiful goddess. Bringing hands to the heart center and twisting for another qigong inspired movement for the serpent. Creating a snake-like S shape from side to side, really twisting and opening up the shoulders, pressing the palms together, and growing up your serpent, slow and steady, journeying up, finding a fluid movement. Slowly, side to side, moving the hands, journeying all the way up to the sun. Exhaling, forward folding, keeping a soft bend to the legs or a soft bend to the spine if you have straighter legs, keeping a straighter spine here. Swaying side to side if you have a block, you can find a static movement more still. We're finding a little bit of fluidity here. Softly swaying side to side as I'm looking at the river upside down. It's beautiful to see the river behind me. Slowly journeying to the opposite side of the mat, coming in for a runner's lunge here. Rounding into the four corners of the foot in the front and the hind foot tracking ankle behind knee, hips facing the short edge of the mat. Tuning in, palms kissing palms, putting a blanket under that knee to support the knee and the foot. And walking forward and stretching, really connecting that foot into the earth like glue and that hind foot. And you can drop it back in, or you can place moving that out of the way, coming in for a lizard. So dropping that left foot more towards the outside of the mat, or you can keep that on the foot and coming down on the elbows, allowing that knee to drop on the outside of the elbow. Really opening up the hip, rounding and rooting into the foot here. Having little chatty Kathy June, who's not really aware of that I'm doing my vlog, but just chatting up her mama. Inhale, rising up, switching, bringing that heel towards the pelvis for Ekopada Kapotasana for the pigeon. Really bringing the weight. Oh, hello, everybody. The weight off of the feet and into the hips. You can gently rest the forehead down onto the arms, down onto the earth, or if you have a block or a pillow. Really allowing those hips to sink into the earth, allowing the feet to let go. As you can truly be rooted into the earth and connected to your body in this moment. Breathing a breath and shining that heart as the sun and opening up with a deep breath. Exhaling. Inhale, raising up. Exhaling the opposite foot back for a plank pose here, squeezing at the glutes, powering through the shoulders. Exhaling the opposite foot on the outside for a lizard, bringing that hind foot down and tracking that heel, ankle, and knee. And exhaling and really opening up the hip on the opposite side, sinking into this moment. Just taking a breath to breathe. In yoga, when we hold a pose for longer than a few breaths, we can really open up the deep connective tissue and reap the benefits. Exhaling, pressing back and moving that pillow, coming in for Ekopada Kapotasana. If you're like me and a hip likes to pop off the earth, I like to put a blanket or a pillow under my booty. Exhaling and resting into the earth for this beautiful hip opening. Really breathing into the heart. And exhaling. Filling up your glass of water inside. And pouring your water out. Each breath cleansing and clearing and detoxifying your system. And allowing you to root into the earth and really open up those feet and rest those feet that we spend so much hard work at. Exhaling, palms, starfishing the hands into the earth, posting up that hind foot, coming in for a plank pose up to downward facing dog, coming into tabletop position, coming in for cow and cat, rooting into a starfish hand, exhaling, journeying with the spine, tail and chin journeying up to the sun. Slowly inhale, raising up like a black cat, tucking tail into chin. Exhaling, finding a movement that feels good for you. Raising up and dropping at the navel. I love really finding a free movement, so swaying the hips. Really moving that back body, maybe swaying back, coming in for Bhaktasana, devotional. Sit bones back to the heels. allowing the hands to sink into the earth, but be active with opening up and breathing that breath, filling up your glass of water inside and sinking into the moment, exhaling like there's a marble and your job is to push it up for Bhujangasana, the cobra. Inhale, raising it for the slight back bend, twisting to the left side. You can bring those heels up, twisting to the right. If this feels good, you can bring those feet up, sinking down into the earth here. Inhale, raising up for a full locus here. Exhaling down to the earth. Inhale, raising up the shoulders, raising up the back of the body. Exhaling, the right foot bending at the knee, bending at the opposite knee. Inhaling, for this variation, you can swim back and just keep your body, or you can grab each ankle and rise up at the chest here. Rising up at the chest, squeezing into those back body, raising the heels up for this bow pose. Dhanurasana, really strengthening and feeling the openness of the feet. Exhaling, resting down to the earth, allowing your forehead to rest here. Just resting for a moment and feeling the energy as your feet are open and you're really rooted into the inhaling to tabletop, coming back for Bhaktasana. Sit bones back, and if Jack's falling on my back like he does, just going with the flow, Joe. Little monkey man. Exhaling, twisting at one side, allowing the sit bones to come up and sit up, nestling arch over arch, twisting at the left side, opening up, dropping that shoulder, inhale, rising to the opposite, just for a nice twist to neutralize out the spine. Exhaling, twisting at the opposite side, arch, twisting, arch, raising up at the spine. Exhale, twisting for a breath to the left. Inhale, raising in neutral to the right here. Exhaling, sit bones to the earth and allowing yourself to journey down each vertebrae by vertebrae to the earth for Apanasana, double wing reliever. Squeezing the knees, hugging them up into the chest as you root it into the earth. Exhaling, sinking, and allowing those legs to come to our final pose of surrender, Savasana. Allowing yourself to relax and find ease here as you're truly rooted into the earth. Letting go at the heels and the feet and the toes. Bringing love and healing into the feet. And slowly just taking a moment here. And if it feels good, you can roll to a side. I love curling up in the fetal position here. It just makes me feel so warm and cozy. And just bring love and the intention of opening and healing at your feet. And you can stay in your Savasana, your pose of surrender, or you can come up for a Savasana or Bhaktasana. And just, if you are up, not Bhaktasana or your Sukhasana, you can rub at your feet, bringing hands to heart center, up to the third eye, rolling in a circle. Namaste, my beautiful friends. I'm so grateful for this practice. I love you very much.
Tried to chain her.